friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In today's video, we'll try to learn from basics of MS Excel to some advanced level features of MS Excel. For our example, we are using student data. You can use any data which you want to work on and try to do along with me so that you'll have a good hands-on experience with me. First, let me say you about the basics of MS Excel. The cell which is in rectangular shape here, you can see it highlighted. This is called cell of MS Excel. There are 64,000 rows and 64,000 columns around available in each sheet of a document. You can create multiple sheets by just clicking the plus icon here. Once you click on plus icon, there's one more sheet created. You can see sheet 3, sheet 2. And remember, you can again name your sheets by just double clicking it and giving a name like something like student marks. For this example, I am using Google's Chrome document. So if you want to name your document, you can rename it on the top left corner here. And this will be saved wherever you want, like whether you want to save it in your drive or something, whatever. We have different options which we have seen in one more video. So let's deep dive into the MS Excel features. Suppose we want to find the total of each student. So how will we do it? Will we manually take the calculator, calculate the total and write it? No. Let's see how will we do it. Remember, whenever you want to type any formula, you have to start with equal to. And remember this fx bar, which is available on the top left corner, is known as formula bar. Either you can type the formula here by clicking on the cell which you want, or you can even directly type it here. There are few functions which are available with MS Excel, like sum, average. Let's explore them. Suppose we type sum. We get few suggestions here. So these suggestions are directly given by MS Excel, and MS Excel is smart enough to understand which rows to be summed up. But for our example, let's not go with the suggestions given and click on the formula bar which I have shown you, and let's mention the cell numbers on which we want to do it. So for us it will be B2, I guess. B2 again, give colon to mention till which cell you want it to be summed. We'll write something like B2, close the bracket and click enter. Here is the sum of all the subject marks of Shyam. So again, it is a big process if we have to do same thing for each and every student. So now within 1 second, we'll find the total of 21 students which are available by just clicking on this left side corner here. So from here, directly click and drag it here down, and we'll see the sum of each and every student here. So it was such an easy process where within seconds, I guess within less than 2 seconds, we could find the total of each and every student. Similarly, if we want to find the percentage of each and every student, what do we need to do is, any formula you want to start with, begin with equal to. Once you begin with equal to, then suppose we want to find average, let's see whether we have something up for average. So there is average suggestion given. Let's see what it is. Average, and let's select the total for this, which is total is F2. Let's mention as F2 by number of subjects, which is 4. Let's click enter and see. The average is 62 here, which is percentage of the student. So again, for anything, once you perform a single option, just go on the right hand side corner and just drag it below, and you will see various percentages of all the students without calculating. So I think within less than 20 seconds you were able to calculate it for whole class, which is 21 students here right now. Similarly, this can be done in horizontal format as well. Suppose you want to find the sum of all the English marks of students, just type equal to sum bracket opens B2 to sum B21 in our case. Let's see. Oh, here the, this is the total I have to find out is sum. So just do one thing. Change this sum to average. A-B-E-R-A-G-E. And just click on enter. Here you could see the class average of each and every student. Once you find the average, click on this and again drag it in this way, so that you will find get the average of each and every student here. So as you can see, it is taking us seconds to find out. Now let's see conditional formatting. Before conditional formatting, let's look into how can we find grades of the students. So to decide the grade of a student and whether he has failed or not, we need to check various conditions, whether he has crossed his 40% in each subject, and then after he crosses 40%, what is the total percentage he has retained in all the subjects. Based on that, we can give a grade to a student. So let's see how can this be done. So this can be done by using equal to and try with if condition and open the bracket. Once you open the bracket, you will be given various suggestions. And here is an example where you can see A2 equal to 4. So what does this means is, if this condition is satisfied, then print this, else print this. So if else, you can take it like that, like if this statement is true, then print this, else print this. So let's not go into such complex things directly. Let's understand this thing with the help of example, which will make the things much easier. So for now, we need to find whether every subject marks is greater than 40. So we can type something like B2 greater than 40. Or let's see, for fail, how will we give condition? Less than 40, comma, give it as failed, F-A-I-L-E-D, okay? Now, instead of giving past, we can even directly give next condition now. Like if, so it will be like else if. So, C2 get less than 40. Less than 40, comma, again it will be failed because he has failed in math subject now. So again give a comma and write another if statement, if D2 less than 40, again it will be failed because he has failed in social subject now. Just see the logic and how things work. Once you understand the logic for one example, you can perform it for any example which you are using. Now let's take E2 less than 40, comma, what to be done? It is less than 40, so he'll be failed. If now, once everything is greater than 40, which means none of the statement has succeeded till now. So now we can directly consider the percentage which we have and find out what can be his grade. So for now, let's see G2 greater than, or we can give something like less than 60. So it means he is greater than 40 and less than 60. So his division can be something like third division or second division. Comma. If suppose this statement has also passed, but he is something above 60, like 65 or 75. First, let's see up to 60 to 75. So, if his G2 is less than 75, then he can be directly said as second division. Comma, suppose he is more than 75, something 75 to 100. So if G2 is less than 100, then give him as first division. So now let's close. Once you start closing the bracket, you can see that the bracket which you have closed, both the opening and closing brackets have been highlighted. So continue closing all the brackets till the last first bracket, which is open near B2 of the first statement, is being highlighted. So let's see. One more comes up, and I think now we are near B2. You can once you close all the brackets, just click enter and see if the statement shows that student has failed. So let's check, verify if it is really true for all the cases. So again the same process applies. Click on this and just drag it down, and once you drag it, you can find that yes, this has successfully executed calculating the grade for each and every student. It has failed. Here you can see failed 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 students who have failed. There is only one first division, because no, there's two first divisions here and here. So next our thing will be, we'll look at conditional formatting, which is instead of again, now this is really hard to find out how many have failed, how many, suppose principal or some our boss asks, show me the report of all the students or all the employees of our organization. So it will be really tough to just sit and analyze there that who has failed, who has not failed. It would be much easier if things can be shown in graphical manner. So let's see how can we make this in a graphical manner. So as per our business requirement, we need to present this data in form of some graphical manner so that it can be easily understood, and senior authorities, whoever might be in the organization, do not have much time to sit and analyze each and every aspect of data. So let's see how can we analyze the whole information in the form of some chart or something so that it is much easier to understand. In this video I am going in a slower manner. Once you are perfect with it, hardly it will take you 10 seconds to perform this action. First of all, select all the rows. Here we are selecting student name and the subject marks. It is not required to select total percentage and grade for this analysis. So just after selection, click on insert and just select the chart option to see what happens. So we can see that the whole data is represented in the form of bar graph. Now even this can be changed, like what kind of chart you want to show up, like whether you want horizontal bars for each student, where you can see here you can analyze easily which student has reached how much, and here you can even give the total of each student if you want, like to show or grade, whichever column you want. Right now we are not selecting. So once you select, you can even customize this based upon your requirement. Suppose you want to customize different colors or different, like you can click on customize and whether you want to change the chart style, whether you want to change the axis, like here you can see English, Math, Social Language, this can be changed. So this can be directly, this is the title actually which is here. So this can be directly given like something like student analysis. So as you can see, within seconds, now when such a chart is presented, let us copy this chart. You can directly copy the chart and open new sheet and just paste it here, and now just enlarge it so that you can view the data much clearly compared to, because we have the data there, I prefer to take it in one more sheet. There is no mandatory requirement to change the sheet. Now let's see, instead of viewing the data there or checking the colors, within seconds you can like directly analyze who has reached top in each and every subject. And you can see like Radha has reached something around 98 in green, which indicates language. So similarly, you can even see Sneha has reached some 99 or something in English. So similarly, these are various analyses, and based on this, it is much easier to understand what is happening in the data. And this data can be directly presented to anybody, whoever you want. Also remember, you can customize this chart in any way you want. For now, like we took columnar chart, like we can take even axis chart. Actually, it depends on the type of data which you have. Just to explore, let's explore various options which are available and see how things happen. This is also like not so clear enough, but yeah. See, it depends on the data which you have. You can select various charts, and based on your requirement, you can even have pie charts. See, pie charts should be useful if the data is like small enough, with some 10 or 15, but here because it's large enough, so it is little tough to analyze. So this was about charts. Now let's look at various other options which are available with Excel. Now let's see the various toolbar options here. Once you click on edit, there is like undo, redo, cut, copy, paste, which are available with each and everything, like whether it's MS Office, you want to find and replace, you want to delete some specific row or something. Now here important thing is freeze. Freeze is useful. I'll show you. Like once you click on freeze and click on row 1, you want to freeze the row 1. And now what happens is, once you go down, you can observe that although we have moved to some 34th column or something, but the first row is visible throughout the document. How much ever, wherever you go throughout the document, the first row will be same. This is useful to understand because for our case, we are just having 21 students' data, so it is easy to view within one single page. Suppose consider some universities or some organizations' data where you have thousands of students or employees. Then it would be easy to understand the data with the help of this. So once you freeze a row, it will be visible throughout the document, whichever row or column you visit to. Now let's see other option, like this is like suppose you are here and you want to insert some row or column there. So if you click row above, the entire row is being added above the column which you have selected. Let's undo it. And now let's do it for below thing. Same thing happens here, like suppose I have made some student who has roll number 4 here or something like that, just as in the case, and you want to add it exactly below that student, so you can directly add it here directly. Now, same thing with column. If you want to add column to left, column to right, let's see. Let's click and explore. See, you can see that there's a column added to left. Now, let's insert a column to the right. So you can see these things are useful while you are playing around with the document and there is some requirement where you want to either add or remove or anything. Or if you want to add an image in a cell, you can directly click on this image, select an image and just drop it there and it will be inserted within that thing. Also we have different options like function, what kind of function you want. Like I said, these are like average, sum, count, max, these are like general functions. Then you have a list of functions which is provided by Excel to perform various operations. We'll not be looking at this right now, but in another video we'll try to explore each and every option so that we can understand. And if you want to something like database operations like dAverage, dMax, database average, the whole database, you can perform even lookups. Well, lookup is like checking the whole row or column based on your requirement. So you learn a lot from them. In the next video, we'll be even looking at them. We can even add some numbers, date, and you can even select what kind of thing it is, whether it's accounting thing, financial currency or something, and then you can even align your data, whether it's left, right, middle, top, text rotation, you want to rotate some text in some any format. We are not looking at it right now. In one more video we'll be looking at this in depth in for each and everything. Right now we are just looking at the basics which will be useful in day-to-day life. Again, there is some important option called create a filter. This is useful if you want to sort the data according to some conditions or something. This can be useful. Now let's click on slicer is also similar thing. Then there's one more thing, one more option called protect ranges. If you might have seen, once you click on data, protect ranges, what this allows is, once you click on this and select a range, some range, and then click on protect range, once your data is exported, the other person cannot edit this data. So we can give kind of permissions. So once you set the permissions, it is restricted only to me, so only I can edit this. Similarly, suppose you send this data to some third party or some other person, only you can edit the data, or you can give the permissions to email ID that the person can edit the data. It's useful in protecting the sheet. There's one more thing called trim white spaces. So this is useful when you have some raw data where there's some, suppose we have this second division or first division and we have space in that, and there's a requirement that you want to remove the space or something, you can just select the data and click on trim white spaces. It will just remove the white spaces which is displayed in that text. Remove duplicates, let's try and see what happens. Let's try on this and see how this works, okay? For grade, let's select this. And let's go to data and click on remove duplicates. See what happens is, like, there will be only four things. First field, second division, there's some error with that, because second division should be, maybe it might be white space error that I might have given some white space extra in one of them. It's just displaying like this. Rest everything is removed because it feels that It has been repeated. So you want, there's some business case where you want to remove duplicate data, you can use that option. Yeah, I have shown you protected and how to, you know, remove duplicates. Let's see tools option. You can create a form. Macros will be looking in another video, that is little advanced level concept, which you will be not required to know if you are just using it for general day-to-day purposes. You can even protect the entire sheet through some password or something, so that the person who opens this needs to give a password or something. So it is same thing like whom you want to give the permission to, whether you want to give it to me or you want to customize this. Like here we can give different names or email addresses to whom the permissions can be given. Names can be used within the organization so that the person within the organization can use this thing. So these are about protecting sheet. Notification rules, you can add notification rules like somebody edits it or some changes made it, you can have the notification notified through email every day. And you can even set whether you want notification for each and every event which is occurring in the sheet, or you want it on daily basis, or you want something like when a user submits the form. So all these things will be useful when you are working in organization and you have the rights to define what to be done with the sheet. This will be really helpful. And these are various formatting options, like you want to make it bold, let's make this bold and see how things happen. No, we want this to be bold, or you want to increase the size of this to some bigger value, something like 24. This is done for single one, but the whole text should be selected for things to work properly. For now, 12 would be correct thing to go with. So this is about bold, and we can make it italic if you require. And if you want, you can add some text color, like let's suppose we select these columns and we want to give some color like red to it, so everything turns red. And this is about fill color, what kind of color you want to give inside the rectangular box. So it's red, let's go with some dark color like yellow, or light color like yellow. See, so this is helpful for that thing, so that you can give colors. This is up to your requirement, how you want to design the whole sheet and how you want the look to be. So this was about today's video, where we saw this borders option is useful when you want to apply some border. Suppose you want to take print of this. So what happens is it will not show the columns in the document. What happens is it will directly print it without any kind of borders in it. So what you can do is select the given row, click on borders option, and select the type of border you want, all border or inner border or vertical border, horizontal border, or just outer border, or left, right, up, down, whatever border you want. It's better, good standard is to go with all border. So it makes border available throughout the data, and whenever you print, the border is also printed along with it. This is also very good option. One more option is like find and replace. Suppose you want to replace first division, you want to replace it with something like, let's take some random value so that it is clear enough. Let's do it once again. First, and do you want to replace it with something like excellent? And you can select how do you want to match. So let's click on replace all and click on OK and click on done and see things have worked. There's some error happening there. I think we have not selected the entire row. We need to select this thing to for things to happen. It is required that wherever you want to perform some action, you need to select that row unless you want to perform it through entire document. So first will become excellent. You see here you can select student marks, or it is like H4 to H21. So okay, and match case, and let's click on replace all. There's no match found yet. Match case with content, replace all. So this is usually useful when you have large amount of data. So here actually first division is not been replaced. I don't know, there's some error with the document. Actually it should be replaced directly. Let's try once again and see. Yeah, here we can select all sheet or this sheet. Okay, let's select FIR 18. I think I was giving a typo there. And let's replace it excellent. Match case, click on find. Replace all, there are no matches found. There's some error with this. It got issued. So this was about find and replace and all different icons available, and you can even add up notes to this, any kind of if you want to zoom the data. Suppose we want to zoom to some 150%, we can enlarge it. And once things are ready, you can directly export this in the form of whatever format you want, whether it's PDF, web, comma separated. Let's go with standard of PDF. Let's see how things work. So we can even specify how we want to store, whether it's portal or landscape. Standard is to go with landscape, and different formatting options, everything we can select as per our requirement, which you want to show notes. You can even add header and footer to the document, page numbers, workbook title, sheet name, current date, current time, and you can add whatever fields you require and just click on export, and it's downloaded here. Let's open this and see how this looks like. You can see the example sheet, which is the name of the document, which is displayed on the top. And let's zoom a little bit and see how things are being seen. You can see as we selected these rows here, these are in bold color border, and you can see that date and everything is being displayed here. So this was about today's video. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.
Don't forget to subscribe to my channel and hit the bell icon so that you'll never miss a video from Best Way to Study. And also don't forget to like and share this video.